So there's a couple ways we can go.
Okay.
Now, there's obviously, like, the Modern Families of the world, where we could just steal any of the moms and plug and play. Mm-hmm. We could go A-list celebrity with the Danny character and have the mom be, like, our Ellen Pompeo, not that she's A-list now, but have her be, like, the staple of our show. If our show runs 10 years, she's the one that has to stay.
Ellen Pompeo, you say, huh?
Mm-hmm. You like Ellen Pompeo?
I don't
You pulled out your
her.
Phone and it felt like you were going to show me a picture of you and Ellen.
Ellen Pompeo. This is me and Ellen at the first episode of Grey's Anatomy. I liked Ellen Pompeo in Old School, but I've only really watched a little bit of Grey's Anatomy, and in the episodes that I've seen, she seems fine.
So we could do something like that, or we could go legitimate, like, A-list, so we could do like a Julia Roberts kind of person. So it depends on how big we're going. If we're going TV mom, if we're going A-list mom, or if we're going somewhere in between.
Well, you've noticed that in a lot of TV shows, like Big Little Lies and Sharp Objects.
We've got our Reese Witherspoons.
We've got our A-listers in there.
Homecoming.
Yeah. Claire Danes. Oh, Julia Roberts in Homecoming? Yeah. I thought you said Homeland. I was like, Claire Danes.
Claire Danes also, yeah. She is Juliet, so.
And what would this show look like? So here's what we're going to do.
Single mom?
Gotta be.
Okay.
Yeah. And so, these are her, and one's her best friend, and one is her husband's sister.
Straight mom? Gay mom? Doesn't matter.
That's something we can explore.
Yeah.
Okay. It's 2019.
It is 2019.
We can really do whatever. So if you remember, Jesse was Danny's wife's brother, and Joey was Danny's best friend. And then they all came together to help raise the girls.
So we got to pick the best friend and the in-law. But first, I think we need to start with Danny.
Yes.
Who is Danny? Now, which of those routes sounded most appealing to you?
I think we go with the new A-list, like the new TV A-list.
So, like, do you think that Elizabeth Banks is too big for this role?
Yes, but also no.
And also, how old are we talking? Are we picking 40?
40. Like between 40 and 45 is our lead. Because, you know, parents are getting older these days and people are having babies later.
They could also be 30 because how old is their oldest at this point? Probably.
Let's just say DJ is 15.
So even if you had the kid when you were 20, you could be 35.
Sure. Okay.
So if you had the kid when you were young. So anywhere from 35 to 45 we're casting right now.
Sounds
so
good.
In our casting breakdown, in our breakdown for our auditions, 30 to 45.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why.
Where's your head going on this one?
I keep going blonde, and I don't know why. Like, I'm seeing this, like, short little blonde dude, but I need to kick that because I'm eliminating a lot of.
Do you know where my head goes?
Where?
And I don't know how old she is at this point.
Who?
I like America Ferrera. I feel like she would play.
Mm-hmm.
I think for whatever reason she's very matriarchal.
I haven't heard her name in a while.
Yeah,
in a while. What is she working on?
She
was born in 1984.
America says she's 35 years old, depending on when her birthday is.
She's so young looking.
Yeah, I hope people say that about me.
She's great, though.
She is great. She's also in that great movie, Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants, where you could pick any one of those girls out to be the lead. An Alexis Bledel, an Elizabeth Moss, a Carrie Russell. These are all recent Emmy winners or Emmy nominees.
Why did you avoid Blake Lively?
I didn't say Blake Lively yet, but I love Blake Lively. But here's what I think. I think
born 87.
Here's the thing. You have Danny, who's the father, the patriarch. It doesn't have to be that, like, stunning of a person. Uncle Jesse was a sexual icon. So Aunt Jesse has to be a sexual icon. You need that, like, young, awesome,
hot
hair, everything.
Okay.
Like, is it a Emily Ratajkowski? Or
I think that's exactly what it is.
Is
but
it?
She is super duper young, though. Do we want that?
Yeah, she's Fyre Festival young.
She's
we need
a
to go.
Little too close to DJ's age.
Right, right. Like she's like 24, right?
Yeah.
If that.
I don't even know
how old she is. But
I don't know either. What about Megan Fox?
As Danny?
No. As hot bestie.
Okay, Megan Fox did appear in New Girl. And she was actually fantastic in New Girl as Jake's love interest.
She was excellent.
Or as Nick's love interest.
She was excellent, and she's a damn piece.
Megan Fox might be one of the most attractive people to ever walk this planet.
Oh, of all time.
Okay.
Of all time.
So
I mean, it doesn't have to be her, but it kind
of
does.
It sort of kind of has to be.
So right? Other than the fact that it doesn't have to be her, it also has to be
How old is Megan Fox? And also, Uncle Jesse, if you forget, Uncle Jesse was also younger than Danny. So there could be a few years separated by these.
Megan Fox was born in 86.
Okay, so she's Amanda's age, 32. Ooh, my wife's going to be pissed. I just said her age.
Sorry, Amanda. You look amazing. You are not a day over 21. Yeah.
Thank you.
That body, though.
Megan Fox? Let's just put a Megan Fox question mark.
You know who it also could be?
Who?
Olivia Wilde.
Ooh, and Olivia Wilde's so hot right now.
Olivia Wilde is. And.
And she, awesome. I met her, hung out with her. Awesome, she's awesome.
And I'll never forget her in The OC as Alex, who was the hot, like, lesbian with the purple strip of hair. And she was just, like, the sexy woman on the scene. And
she ran that club, that live music venue.
Oh, she was so hot. Everybody put that purple streak in their hair afterwards.
Oh, man.
Blue one, pink one, purple one.
Yeah.
Could be her. She was born in 84. So it could be Megan Fox, could be Olivia Wilde. We'll decide about that later. Mm-hmm.